Recorded Books presents The Leaf Detective, How Margaret Lowman Uncovered Secrets in the Rainforest by Heather Lang, illustrated by Jana Christie, narrated by Sandy Rustin. Meg loved how leaves burst into the world and unfurled. She admired their different shapes, colors, and textures. After 20 years of thinking about them, reading about them, studying them, Meg wanted to understand them, to discover their stories. How did they survive? How long did they live? Why did they die? But looking at leaves from the ground gets a rainforest scientist only so far. Meg knew she had to find a way to go to the leaves, to the treetops. We had already been to the moon and back, and nobody had been to the top of a tree. Before 1979, most scientists studied rainforest treetops through binoculars. Some also cut trees down or sprayed them with chemicals and collected the dead leaves and insects that fell to the ground. Meg Lowman had been a leaf detective ever since she was a young girl in the 1950s in Elmira, New York. Shy and studious, Meg rarely spoke in school. It pained me if I was ever called upon in class. Instead, she found comfort and friendship and quiet excitement in plants. She built tree forts and collected twigs, leaves, and wildflowers to study and identify, to press and label, swamp thistle, devil's paintbrush, forget-me-nots. I was literally the only one in my town like myself. Meg wrapped herself in nature like a soft blanket. In college, Meg fed her passion with science. She was a young woman in a jungle of men, with no women to lead the way. One professor refused to let her in his class because she was a woman. Still, she stuck like sap to her passion and followed it to graduate school and the tropical rainforests of Australia. No one at Sydney University had studied the rainforest before. Tropical rainforests receive at least 60 inches of rain per year. The hot, humid environment encourages lots of different plants to grow. This diversity supports a huge variety of animal species. In the dark, damp forest, the trees rose up to distant rustling, squawks and screeches, shadows in the treetops. How could she get up there? Using seatbelt straps, Meg sewed a harness. From a metal rod, she welded a slingshot. Pull, aim, release, fire! Meg launched a lead weight on a line again and again, until at last it caught around the sturdy branch of a coachwood tree. Most rainforest trees are between 60 and 150 feet tall. Their branches form the canopy, a big umbrella that shades the forest floor. At first, Meg flailed. Upside down, right side up. The steamy forest painted her with a coat of sweat. Swinging and twisting, she dangled like a worm on a hook. I was frozen with fear. Meg inched up the rope, but she worried. What if the branch breaks? Will my sewing hold up? Will a bird peck through my rope? What sits waiting in the treetops? At last, splashed with flowers and sunlight, the canopy. The treetops swayed back and forth. Flies whizzed. Lizards lingered. A black weevil sucked leaf juices. Sweat bees landed on her arm for a lick of salt, and the jungle's music danced all around her. From then on, I never looked back or down. Insects eat leaves by chewing them, piercing and sucking from the leaf, or tunneling in and eating the inside of the leaf. To Meg, it was a secret world with brilliant parrots and sleepy koalas, slithering pythons, and busy ants. And leaves, lovely leaves, large and small, shiny and prickly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.